Hello students, I am Sachitraka. Welcome to Cars Physics. We are continuing chapter number 4, that is moving charge and magnetism. In previous lectures we have discussed the fundamental concept of magnetic field, and of course we have discussed moving charge in a magnetic field experiences a force. It is found experimentally that when a charge moves in a magnetic field, then it experiences a force, and that force is found to be perpendicular to both the direction of velocity of charged particle and direction of magnetic field. Okay. In previous lecture we have discussed the force experienced by the charged particle is Q into V cross B, where V is velocity of charged particle and B is magnetic field. Okay, so this is expression for force experienced by charged particle in a magnetic field. In this lecture, we will discuss about Lorentz force. Lorentz force. Okay, as we have discussed, if a charge moves in a magnetic field, then it experiences a force. Okay. And previously we have already discussed in electrostatics, when a charge moves in electric field, it experiences a force, of course. If a charge in the electric field, then it experiences a force. Means, a charge may be at rest or may be in motion in the electric field, but the charge experiences a force. Okay. But in magnetic field, the static charge or the charge at rest doesn't experience any force as it is found from experiment. Okay. In magnetic field, the charge at rest doesn't experience any force. Only a moving charge may experience a force. So, we have discussed in previous lecture, if a charge moves either parallel or anti-parallel to the direction of magnetic field, then the force experienced by charged particle in the magnetic field is zero, or no force is experienced by the charged particle if the charged particle moves either parallel or anti-parallel to the direction of magnetic field. So, in coming lectures, we will discuss about different directions of velocity with magnetic field. Okay. So, in separate heading, in this lecture, we will discuss Lorentz force. So, what is Lorentz force? Lorentz force is the resultant force. The resultant force experience by a charged particle when it moves in a space or region where both electric and magnetic field are present. Okay. Suppose in a space or region, both electric and magnetic field are present. So, what is Lorentz force? It is the resultant force experienced by a charged particle when it moves in a space or region where both electric and magnetic field are present. Of course, we have discussed now itself, if a charge is either at rest or in motion in the electric field, it will experience a force. But a static charge or charge at rest in magnetic field doesn't experience a force. Only moving charge in magnetic field experiences a force. Okay. So, as to get resultant force, due to presence of both electric and magnetic field, we are taking the charge is in motion. So, The resultant force is called as Lorentz force. This is Lorentz force F. So Lorentz force is given as the vector sum of forces experienced by charged particle due to both electric and magnetic field. So resultant force or Lorentz force is vector sum of forces experienced by the charged particle due to presence of electric field and magnetic field. Okay, the moving charge experiences a resultant force in the combined electric and magnetic field. That resultant force is called as Lorentz force, which is vector sum of force experienced due to electric field and force experienced due to magnetic field. Fe represents force experienced by charged particle due to presence of electric field, and Fm is force experienced by charged particle due to the presence of magnetic field. Okay, so resultant force is called as Lorentz force, or you may say this is magnetic Lorentz force, this is electric Lorentz force, and sum of these two forces is Lorentz force, resultant force. Okay, then if a charged particle is either at rest or in motion in an electric field, then as we know, force experienced by charged particle due to presence of electric field is QE. If magnitude of charge is Q and electric field is E, then force experienced by charged particle is QE. And similar, force experienced by charged particle due to the presence of magnetic field, as we have discussed in just previous lecture, that's given as Q into V cross B. Okay. So Lorentz force is resultant of electric force and magnetic force. So final expression for Lorentz force is Q force due to electric force. Sorry, force due to electric field. And force due to magnetic field is given as Q into V cross B. Okay. And finally, we may write expression for Lorentz force is E, bring Q common, E plus V cross B. This is final expression for Lorentz force. Means resultant force experienced by charged particle in both combined magnetic and electric field. Then our next discussion in today's lecture is rate of work done by the charged particle in the combined electric and magnetic field. Okay, so we have already discussed in previous lecture, if a charged particle moves in a magnetic field, then the force experienced by the charged particle, and as it is found from experiment, the force experienced by charged particle due to the presence of magnetic field is perpendicular to both velocity of charged particle and direction of magnetic field. If force and velocity are perpendicular to each other, then obviously force and displacement are perpendicular to each other. Then work done by magnetic field, work done by magnetic field on a moving charge is always zero. Means force experienced by charged particle due to the presence of magnetic field and displacement are mutually perpendicular to each other. So net work done by the charged particle or on the charged particle moving in a magnetic field means due to the magnetic field is zero. Okay, we have discussed it in just previous lecture. Now, rate of doing work means work done per unit time. Okay, if work is zero, then rate of doing work is also zero. So let's prove it. This is expression for Lorentz force. Okay, then next is rate of work done due to Lorentz force. due to Lorentz force.
Suppose in a space or region, both electric and magnetic field are present. Then what is work done? Okay. Due to Lorentz force, work done either on the charged particle or by the charged particle. We are finding the magnitude of work done means amount of work done. So, work done. Let work done is dW. If displacement of the charged particle is dS, or you may take dL, small a. Work done by charged particle or work done on charged particle is dW due to displacement dL. Then dW is equal to F dot dL, where F is Lorentz force. Okay. Then the rate of doing work. Rate of work done. dW by dt. Rate of work done is dW by dt, and that's equals to F dot dL into 1 by dt. dW by dt, 1 by dt into F dot dL. Okay. Then dW by dt is 1 by dt. In case of force F, we may write QE plus Q into V cross. Okay. The stretch point is QE plus Q into V cross V. This is expression for Lorentz force dot displacement. Okay. Then dW by dt 1 by dt QE into dL plus Q into V cross V dot dl. Okay. Then rate of doing work dw by dt. dw by dt rate of doing work, that's equals to qe dot dl by dt plus q into v cross v dot dl by. Then dW by dt is Q. Electric field is E. dL by dt. dL is displacement. Dt is interval of time. Then dL by dt. Rate of change of displacement. We may write velocity of charge particle V. V is rate of change of displacement. Velocity of charge particle is V. V is equal to dL by dt. Similar. Plus Q in V cross V dot V. Okay. Q into V cross V. dL by dt is V. Okay. Then as it is found, this is force experienced by charged particle in a magnetic field. Force experienced by charged particle in the magnetic field. Okay. And force is perpendicular to velocity. Means, if this is force experienced by charged particle in a magnetic field and this is velocity of charged particle, then between force experienced by charged particle and velocity of charged particle is 90 degree. Means, force is perpendicular to velocity. Of course, it is clearly be understood that V cross V dot is equal to 0. V cross V dot V is 0. Is it clear? Then dW by dt, this becomes 0. dW by dt is QE dot V. So here, rate of doing work is only due to electric field. Rate of doing work due to magnetic field is 0. Since force experienced by charged particle due to the presence of magnetic field and velocity of charged particle are mutually perpendicular to each other, the dot product of force and velocity is 0. So, rate of doing work is due to only the presence of electric field or force experienced by the electric field is QE. So, rate of doing work is due to force experienced by the charged particle due to electric field only. Okay. So, if rate of doing work due to force experienced by the charged particle in magnetic field is zero, then work done by magnetic field is also zero, as we have already discussed in the previous lecture. Okay. So, this is about rate of work done due